Today I'm going to take a look at Tony Williams' use of Swiss Army Triplets in the context of the song Mr. Spock from his band Lifetime and Beyond, right after this. Welcome. Today we're going to take a look at Tony Williams' use of the Swiss Army Triplet. But before I get into it, make sure to hit the red subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you know every time I upload a new video. Tony Williams, what can I tell you? Virtuoso, prodigy. He was known to have played with Miles Davis as a teenager. I think he was 15 or 16 years old. Yikes. In any case, check out those records from the mid-60s. He was part of the second quintet with Herbie Hancock and Ron Carter, Wayne Shorter, of course, with Miles. In any case, Tony Williams, one of his favorite rudiments is the Swiss Army Triplet. Now, I was hip to the Swiss Army Triplet back in my university days at McGill University. My teacher, Pierre Belouze, gave us a book, or had us buy a book, called Details of the Swiss Basel Style of Drumming by Ellen C. Benson. Now, you can go online and trying to find that book, but I'll put a link down below where at least you can, I think you have to subscribe or pay for it or something, you can find it there. I wasn't able to find it easily in a way that you can purchase it. In any case, in that book, the Swiss, who, by the way, Switzerland was one of the first places we saw the recorded rudiments, like written rudiments. Yeah, comes in from Switzerland, I think, in the 14th century. This style of drumming, the Swiss Basel style, they take the 40 rudiments that you find on the Percussive Art Society rudiment chart, and they write them out differently, and they phrase them differently. They also add a few embellishments that the Percussive Art Society rudiments don't have. A few things are a little different. Were probably more akin to the original rudiments found in Switzerland so many years ago, or centuries ago. So in any case, Tony Williams' use of the Swiss Army Triplet, he often uses it as triplets. He also can convert it into 16th notes, and he also uses the Swiss Army Triplets in a way that he grooves with the ride cymbal. So what I've done is I've played the solo off the top with Tony. I highly recommend you trying to do that once you learn this solo. It's pretty cool, and you can really appreciate how fast he's playing. Yikes, hard to keep up. In any case, I took the three examples of the Swiss Army Triplets in that solo and wrote them out for you. Also, I worked up a few exercises that you can do to help you get a little more facility with the Swiss Army Triplet itself. And I will put those out. It's about, let's see, three different examples of that. And also, make sure to download the solo and learn it. It's pretty interesting. Tony likes to use his hands. You know, I heard a clinic of him once from Boston, I think, many years ago, mid-80s or early 80s. And he talks about that. You know, he talks about how it's great to develop your ability with your hands to get around the kit. You know, these days, you know, a lot of drummers are caught up with the hands, but also incorporating the hands and feet, mixing up a lot more. You know, he's very focused on the hands, probably, you know, due to his own inspirations, like Art Blakey, Max Roach, who are masters at that. Okay, so let's get to it. Great, so let's start by deconstructing exactly what a Swiss Army Triplet is. It's a triplet, naturally, but the sticking is right, right, left. And, of course, you can do that in reverse, left, left, right, and you put a flam in front of each set of triplets. So here it is without the flams. One, two, three. Reverse. With the flams. Reverse, okay, so pretty simple, right? And you can play that in triplets. I'm obviously playing chord note triplets at this tempo. Then of course you can play that in 16ths or eighth notes as well. All right, so here's the exercise, the first exercise that goes from playing actual eighth note triplets to 16th notes in the Swiss Army triplet style. Now, yeah, that really feels pretty interesting when you play the triplets converted to 16ths, so not really triplets anymore, the 16th notes, or when you go from ternary to duple, the rudiment creates a hemiola effect, 3 against 2. So the accents or the flams, those accents give you the impression of going over the bar line. Okay, so that's a good way to sort of work that up, just to get accustomed to the triplets. All right, now let's dive right into how Tony uses those triplets. It's serious business, okay? The first one that he does in the solo is actually pretty close to the top, and he plays in 16th notes, right? And the flam is on the snare drum and a tom right in front of him. Now, I must note that I don't have as many toms. It doesn't sound like. It sounds like he's got like a regular five-piece kit with an additional 2 floor toms. That's what it sounds like in terms of the pitches of the drums. So some of the ways that I, you know, play the solo aren't dead accurate in terms of the amount of toms. I tried to emulate the sounds best I could. Also, the way that I physically have to execute them are probably going to sit differently on this drum set. Okay, so yeah, we run into those same triplets, the Swami triplets, but in 16th notes right off the top. And slower. Okay. Now on the fifth system, he actually launches into triplets, actual Swiss Army triplets, distributed on the toms. Now this is exactly where I was talking about, you know, not exactly representing every pitch that he was playing. I had to kind of make do with the amount of drums I have. Okay, and slower. 1, 2, 3, Okay. Then lastly, on the seventh line, this is a real killer, this one. He's playing once again in 16th note mode. And I gotta admit, this one's tough to get. It's pretty fast. 1, 2, 3. Woo! Okay, and slower. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, great. So now we're going to move on and play a melodic approach. This is something that Tony does a lot when he does solos, actual solos, you know, drum features, where he'll play those Swiss Army triplets and distribute them around the toms. So it creates sort of a melodic effect. Check this out. 1, 2, 3. So there you have it, that real melodic feel, and you notice that it has the same hemiola effect, that that reoccurring theme that seems to make the phrase go over the bar line. Okay, so the last example I have is not in the song Mr. Spock, because Mr. Spock is an alien on Star Trek, and also, I had to get that in there somewhere, and also, it's a fusion tune. This example is when Tony Williams plays swing. He often will be playing along, and you'll hear these consistent triplets on the snare drum, usually at a pretty fast tempo, faster than you would normally be able to play it with one hand. And what he's doing, he keeps the drive happening, the quarter note happening on the ride cymbal by playing Swiss Army triplets. So the way I wrote it in the exercises is first you see it with flams written properly, and then underneath it, I write how you kind of think of it while you're playing. It's really like the flam is really played together with the triplet. And that way, it creates the drive you want and the rolling triplets underneath. So first I'll play two bars of time, then two bars accenting the first note of the triplet, then I'll play two more bars of time, and then two bars accenting the last note of the triplet to create an upbeat effect. All right, here we go. Yeah, so that's a good look into Tony Williams playing and his love of the Swiss Army triplet. Tony Williams had a pretty vast career in his short time on this planet. He died young, I think in his 40s. From prodigy to great composer near the end, he had several of his own projects and collaborated with all of the greatest jazz musicians in history. Make sure you like this video if you like it and share it. Also, you can catch me at aubreydrumlessons.com for more drumming info. I'm also on Instagram. You can follow me there. And lastly, I offer Skype lessons. So just contact me either through the website or DM me, and we can arrange to do Skype lessons. I'm really having fun hanging out with drummers from all over the planet. Okay, so that's it for this video, and I look forward to seeing you all next time. Thanks for watching my video. I'm really glad you did that. Subscribe and click here if you want more performance and lesson videos.